It's a first step in a process that involves not just the White House, but the Congress, the House, and the Senate. And so it's an important first step. It's very important that the Congress hear from the president what his priorities are. We'll take a look at those priorities, and then we'll sort through the entire process. The House will work its will, the Senate will work its will, and out of that, we'll come up, hopefully, with a concurrent budget resolution that will serve the interests of the American public.
What in the budget do you think is possible?
What is possible? I think it is possible to deliver on a lot of the president's spending priorities. Obviously, after last week, we've pushed up our defense number, which we really needed to do. We'd taken a lot of cuts over at the Pentagon that have affected readiness of our military forces, and that's a core constitutional provision that we provide for the common defense. So I think we're set there. His infrastructure program just introduced, I think, is a very doable program. $200 billion of federal money to go with a lot of other money from other sources. Obviously, we have some other issues that the president is very high on. Border security to be one. Opioid treatment is another. So we have a lot of things that the president wants to do, and we want to embrace those ideas and be able to deliver those.
Do you think we're embracing the idea of adding to the deficits?
Well, I think there's going to be an initial near-term addition to the deficit if we can get long-term growth. But look, you can't look at this from the just through the lens of one thing, whether it's a tax cut or whether it's some other process. But if you look at what we've been able to do, if you look at what the president has advocated, we've gone after regulatory reform. We've been very successful there. We've passed the Tax Cut and Jobs Act program. We're putting more money in the hands of people. And while there are going to be some near-term deficit increases, we think the long-term health of the American economy is going to be much better as a result of that. We just heard
the discussion about
3% growth. If we can get sustained 3% growth, then I think we will have achieved a great victory.
Chairman, the Republican Party for so many years has talked about itself as being fiscally responsible, has talked about avoiding deficits and debt. This plan puts $7 trillion on the table. That's in addition to the tax plan. Do you think something's changed within the party?
No, I don't think anything has changed within the party. We're still the party that believes that in a very strong national defense posture. National security is very important to a lot of us, and I think that building the nation's infrastructure is a key to helping jumpstart an economy that's been in some anemic growth pattern for the last several years.
Spending is part of an economic stimulus package?
Well, I'm not going to call it economic stimulus. It's a core requirement of the Constitution to provide for the common defense. So we think it's important.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.